Hello everyone, Professor Franz here. Today we're going to talk about recessionary gap. We start with our economy operating at its potential GDP. So suppose the potential GDP is $500 billion and our aggregate expenditure is equal to our output, meaning our economy is in equilibrium. And this is a good equilibrium because our actual GDP is equal to potential GDP, meaning we have full employment and there is no cyclical unemployment. Now we're ready to talk about recessionary gap. By definition, a recessionary gap is the amount of expenditure we need in order to restore our GDP back to its potential. So for example, suppose we have a recession, and as a result, our aggregate expenditure goes down from AE1 to AE2. So now we have a new actual GDP, $400 billion, which is lower than our potential GDP, $500. So in order to restore our GDP from $400 back to its potential, we will need to increase our aggregate expenditure. But by how much? By exactly the amount of recessionary gap. And graphically, that will be the distance between AE1 and AE2. In our example, our potential GDP is 500 and our current actual GDP is 400 billion due to a recession. So we want our GDP to increase by $100 billion. So how much aggregate expenditure do we need to increase in order to restore our economy? So that would be our recessionary gap. We can calculate that recessionary gap by the desired change in GDP divided by our expenditure multiplier. So in our example, our MPC is equal to 0.5. And therefore, our expenditure multiplier is equal to 1 over 1 minus 0.5, which gives you 2. So that's our expenditure multiplier that's equal to 2. We want our GDP to increase by 100 billion. So 100 billion divided by our expenditure multiplier 2 will give you 50 billion. So in this example, our recessionary gap is equal to $50 billion.